Hello everybody, welcome to a new video here in Speed Shop. Today we are back at fashioncar.de. You can see the background. Today we have a very nice CL63 AMG. This is the third generation CL, a W216. So it came on the market in 2006 till 2014. The CL63 has two engines deliveries. In the past you got this one. So 2006 to 2010 you got a 6.2 liter V8. After that the engine changed to a 5.5 bi-turbo. So this particular model is the 6.2 liter V8 or 6200 HCCs. So normal aspirated engine. So what are we going to do today? Show you around the car, show you all the options and special things and do the test drive. So CL63 AMG. Very big car. Was much bigger than its than a W215. Exact numbers, this particular car was 72 millimeters longer than its predecessor because the wheelbase was 70 millimeters longer. Wheelbase is now almost 3 meters, 2955 millimeters, so that's very long. It also was taller, 20 millimeters, and it was wider, 14 millimeters wider than its predecessor, the W215. So it also was heavier. This particular model weighs 2,085 kilos, almost 2,100 kilos, so pretty heavy car. So it delivers 525 horsepower and 630 newton meters from stock. So very big brake calipers, 390 millimeters discs in the front, on 19-inch reels. Am I right? 19-inch? Yes, 19-inch reels, 255 in the front. Very nice batching. And in the back, 275, 40, 19 wheel in the back. So very, very wide tire. Yeah, it's also a very big and heavy car. So interior wise, it's very luxurious. Of course, the doors and also the rear boot is soft close. Pretty nice. What I really like is the open window style. So there's no style in here. I think that shows more of the car, I think. AMG badging, very luxurious seats, also ventilated and heated seats, three positions, memory three positions, fully adjustable. Also the inside of the seat, everywhere, the sides is all adjustable in the command system, command center. I show you that later, that's in here. I show you that in a minute. So we got a lot of space in here. In here, and we also got a cooled compartment in here. You can open that with a small button over there. You got, if you got a bottle or anything else in it. Also telephone is for the control of the command center. So the command system is controlled with this button underneath here. You can turn it front, left, right, up and down, and there's just a push button underneath. So if you put the command system on, you just got this option. In here, this is just a ventilation option. You can select, for example, temperature. Higher or lower. Also you can do it on the other side, same thing for that. So you can change all different settings, auto or different ventilation modes, AC on or off. Or for example you go to the seat options, what I think is really nice. For example you can see here side and sit, so that's your sides, this is your love handles. Back of the seat. You see, for example, if I change this, it's all by air. There's like a sort of compressor inside, so you can completely change the sides of the seats, also the position. I think it's really nice. You can really get your own seating position. You can do the same thing for the passenger. Is also to do with the same button. You also can put this one on a massage seat, so four different settings, so it gives you a massage in the seat, so that's also very nice. So very nice option. And you got also disc and radio controls in here. So yeah, fast switches to the telephone navigation or seat positions or radio. Headrest dropping in the back, just push it. Transmission settings, 720-9 transmission. So everything is very clean in here. Bottles, ashtray in here. Here you've got also your CD load up. You can put your CDs in it. It's a 6 CD changer. You can also put them in here. It's not in the boot, it's in here. Glove compartment. Also in the back, seat is moving. So yeah. Space is big enough, very nice seat in here. Analytical windows, of course, airbags on the side, headrest. Here's the compartment, armrest, because this is a 4-seater. Big compartment in here. Also, cup holder. Got some big compartments also in here. Still also in here. If you're looking for the chassis number, it's in here. I just found it. Chassis number, very nice place, I think. I don't know why they put them there. So yeah. Very luxurious inside. Also, we've got also a sunroof. Very nice, exhaust tips in the back. 4 tips. Opening the boot can be done from the key or the inside of the car, or just by hand. Very big boot, about 500 liters of boot space. Pretty big, it's never been used, I think. Also some things to hang up some stuff. Spare wheel and the jackup, of course, is in here. So you can also close it here. Nice. So driver's side. Nice MG logo. It's a digital dash. This car has done 94,000 kilometers. So I think that is not that much for a big car like this. This car is also the optional night vision camera. So nice. You got a backup camera in here, of course. Oh, nice place. If you can see the headliner, really nice. Of Intara. It looks serious. Very nice. So have a look. Let's have a look. I need a bonnet. It's somewhere here. Yeah, there it is. Also this side, soft close. Some badging, very nice badging. Very big bonnet. So 6.2 liter V8. 6,200 cc's. And if I'm right, so a double overhead camshaft engine, very high compression ratio, 11.3:1. This particular model delivers 525 horsepower and 630 newton meters, so it's the most powerful standard delivered from factory. So this same engine and performance is also in the is also delivered in the S63 and also in the SL63. So this particular car that weighs only 2,100 kilos can do 0 to 100 in 4.6 seconds, so that's pretty fast. Also, there is a badging, and I don't know if you can see it, the guy that built it. So very clean engine bay. So let's have a test drive in this CL63. Very nice big car. Close up all the windows. Makes it a little bit more quiet inside in here. So that's nice. So air conditioning I got on. With the temperature, got the temperature down. So we've got no, the shift lever is not in the middle. It's on the steering wheel. So that's, might have to go a little bit back. There is also a backup camera in it. You can can put the setting in it that you got it on the screen in the mail. In this one it is just off, but you can put it on. So this one is also in S, so I put it back to comfort mode. It's the same setting in all the 722.9 transmissions. You got it on the, you see it on the dashboard. And you also got the settings you can change from manual to sport and just comfort mode. So this particular car is delivered with hydropneumatic suspension. So this is a very high pressure hydraulic suspension that's on the S classes and on the CL classes. Standard on the AMG models. It's the same sort of a system that was also delivered in the W215. So it's developed through, so it's more reliable. But in the earlier models, like a W215, you could also change it to sport mode. This is now when you put it now in sport mode, is when you put it just in S, then the transmission is also gets stiffer. So yeah, this particular model is built between 2006 and 2014. So before this you got a W215. Also when this particular car came on the market, also the 63 engine came in it. That was in 2006, so that's a 6.2 liter V8, like I said. 525 horsepower and 630 newton meters. So in this particular model, like, you got a model range from the C class to the CLS and SL class. In the C class, you got the lessest factory power, 457 horsepower. But the engines are all the same. So in this particular model, you got the most horsepower out of it. So there's 525 horsepower at 6,800 RPM. And from what's very nice is also for a car of this weight is that you got already 400 meters from 2,000 RPM. So that's pretty nice. Pretty nice to have. That's pretty good. So you can also a setting in a dash. I will show you that when I do the acceleration test. You can put into AMG mode and you also see the gear shifts. And you also can see there's also a timer in it. So we can have a look how that works later, maybe. Maybe that's just an acceleration timer. So the sound in this car is really at the background. And for the rest it's really a very comfortable mode. For the rest, it's a digital dash. Only the RPM gauge and your fuel gauge and your temperature is analog, and the rest is all digital. So you also got night vision on this particular model. There was also an option. So for the rest, it feels really like a big car. The seats are really, really, really good. I think it's just awesome. So I can put it to sport mode, but also I think what also is very nice, if I go back to the menu, I can see my oil temperature, and that's 75 degrees, so that's very nice to see. Also got your battery, that's 14 volts, it's giving, and which gear you are in. So for example, if I put it now to S mode, now in 7th gear. You can also always shift with the pedals. If you shift up again to the gear where you from the gear where you came from, it goes back to just to automatic mode. So this 722.9 transmission came on the market in 2005. It was the first time it was delivered in the SLK behind the V8 in 2005. Later on, the other models came. So this particular transmission is changed to a multi-clutch transmission. It was in 2010. Then it was still named CL63, but the engine changed to the M157 engine. That was a 5.5 liter bi-turbo engine. It was still called the 63. And then you also got a multi-clutch transmission. So then you just change the torque for it. But this is not a bad transmission, because this transmission can also lock up in every gear to give you maximum torque delivery. Yeah, I just put the throttle a little bit. This car is only weighing 2100 kilos, empty, so it's almost 2,200 kilos, and you cannot really feel that weight, so pretty surprised me. So the driving precision is just, it's just very nice. It also is getting a lot stiffer in the corners. If you change it to comfort mode, you can feel there's a little bit more body roll, but it's controlled. Very comfortable. Sport mode, you've got a very stiff driving position. Very nice. Sounds very good. So I think we should do an acceleration test. This particular car should do 0 to 100 in about 4.6 seconds. That should be possible. I think it's still pretty fast for a car that, with this weight. So it got 525 horsepower, but it's still a heavy car. So, but it does not feel like that when you drive. So let's see what she can do. So as you can see, I can change the transmission settings. As you can see over here, and you can see it changed from manual to sport. Again, so I'll leave it in sport. So you can also change in this menu all kinds of things, the navigation and the audio, and there's also AMG. So in here you see your oil temperature and the battery, that's 14 volts delivering. Then you also got all kinds of settings. Just how much fuel you're using, how far you can drive, the fuel left in the tank, and just your digital speedometer. The lighting you can change, you can just service, pressures in the tires, all kinds of things. So we leave it on this mode. So I just got the air conditioning is just in auto mode, so I leave it like that. So 4.6 seconds should be possible from 0 to 100. Yeah. So let's see what she can do. Much quieter than the C63 I just drove. For a car like this, this heavy, it is really fast. Brakes are really awesome. Incredible. Very nice. So now we just put it back to comfort mode. And it's, you see the gears going up, it shifts back. So that's very nice. Acceleration is just awesome in a C63. I hope you like this review about this CL63 W2116 model. This particular car is for sale at passioncar.de. There's a link below the video of the website. They really specialize in Mercedes, youngtimers and classics, and also newer models like this. Really specialized in R129 models. They have a lot of them for sale, also AMG models, V12s and V8s. So have a look on their website. If you want to see more of my videos, go to my main page. You can click in the right corner, there's a button. You can also subscribe there. Also more videos and projects and videos I've done in the past. So I hope you liked it and I hope you enjoyed it. If there are any questions, just ask me, send me an email or ask me in the comment section. So give it a thumbs up, share it, and see you next time. Bye bye.